I mean, that the technology of the 3D printing press is, I think, is going to be as revolutionary as the internet. And you're going to see people making all kinds of stuff for their certain circumstances. And as these, they're cheap as it is, and as the raw materials become more varied, and they're not just plastics going into these, you're going to, I think that there you're going to see some real interesting stuff happening. I mean, that's always happened. I mean, the PC revolution did that, right? Is everybody had a computer, right? And then the internet revolution, where everybody had access to the internet, everybody got a website, everybody got plugged into it, and then the mobile revolution. And I think that the 3D printing revolution is really going to be different, because instead of printing, instead of doing mostly intangibles, you know, stuff that, you know, we transfer via bits and bytes, we're going to take those bits and bytes, the creative stuff, and we're going to be able to make that tangible, three-dimensional objects that we can use for different kinds of things. I've been talking to some farmers about that. They're very interested in experimenting with new types of farm equipment. And with a 3D printer, they can make one, they can prototype it cheap, and they can see whether it works or not for, you know, for various climate conditions. I think there's lots going on that we're not seeing. That's why I try to stay plugged into various alternative groups. I try to read some, fringe media and these indie presses and things like that, just to get an idea of what they're thinking about, what makes them buzz. Because I think that's where innovation comes from, is from the edges.